ഹായ് വെൽക്കം ബാക്ക് ടു മൈ ചാനൽ ആശ്രാസ് എജു മന്ദിറിലേക്ക് എവർക്കും സ്വാഗതം. ഇന്നൊരു ട്യൂട്ടോറിയൽ വീഡിയോ ആയിട്ടാണ് ഞാൻ വന്നിട്ടുള്ളത്. പോളി ഫസ്റ്റ് ഇയർ സ്റ്റുഡൻസിന് അനുയോജ്യമായിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു സ്റ്റഡി വീഡിയോസ് ആണ്. അപ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് കാണാം. Hi guys, what's up? This is Asha Sivanaj. Hope you are well. Today we are discussing about the topic carpentry for poly first year students. Already we have completed some of carpentry tools like marking and measuring tools, cutting tools, planing tools. Next we have boring tools. Boring tools are frequently necessary to make round holes in wood. And they are selected according to the type and purpose of the hole. They include bradawl, gimlet, brace, bit and drill. So we have bradawl and gimlet. The bradawl and the gimlet are hand operated tools and are used to bore small holes such as for starting a screw or large nail. This is the figure for boring tools. This is gimlet and this is bradawl. And we have brace. The brace is a tool used for holding and turning a bit for boring holes. So we have some of important boring tools: bradawl and gimlet and brace. And bradawl and gimlet is used for to make a hole that for starting a screw or larger nail, and brace is used for holding and turning a bit for a boring holes. In again, we have some of striking tools. Striking tools include hammers and mallet. Here we have a claw pin hammer. This is the figure for claw pin hammer. And the carpenter more often favors the claw pin hammer because it serves the dual purpose of a hammer and a pair of pincers. Dual purpose of hammer and pair of pincers. For what? The claw is used for pulling out any nails accidentally bent in driving. So here we have claw. It is used for pulling out nails accidentally bent in driving. And these hammers are made in number sizes from 1 to 4, and it has weighing 375, 450, 550 and 675 gram. And here we have another striking tool. This is the picture for mallet. This is the head and this is the wooden handle. And mallet, it is a wooden headed hammer of round or rectangular cross section. This is the wooden headed hammer of round or rectangular cross section. For what? It is used to give light blows to the cutting tools having wooden handles such as chisels and gouges. So you should remember, it is used to give light blows. What is that? Light blows to the cutting tools having wooden handle such as chisels and gouges. So the tools having wooden handle. The mallet, which is used for the light blows. Got it? Then we have holding tools. This is the picture for holding tools like bench vise and G-clamp. To enable the woodworker to cut his wood accurately, it must be held steady. For that purpose, we have a lot of holding tools. There are number of tools and devices to hold wood having its own purpose according to the kind of cutting to be done. Then first we have bench vise. This is the picture for bench vise. Here one jaw is fixed and other is movable. So the whole vise means whole bench vise is made of iron and steel. The jaws being lined with hardwood face which do not mark and which can be renewed as required. Here we have G clamp. It is also one of the holding tools like bench vise. The G clamp is used for smaller work. It consists of a malleable iron frame. It consists of a malleable iron frame that can be swiveled and a steel screw. A steel screw to which it is fitted a thumb screw. Steel screw which is fitted to a thumb screw. And again, last we have some of miscellaneous tools like pincers, screwdriver, etc. This is the picture for pincer. We already studied clopping hammer. Actually, clopping hammer is the substitute for the pincer for pulling out nails. So, pincer is mainly used for pulling out nails, tacks, etc. It consists of 2 amps. Here, the 2 amps we can see. And it has a ball end. It has a ball end here. It has a ball end. And the other arm has a claw. That here we can see a claw in the other arms. And it is for levering out small tacks. Here the ball end, it is used for pulling out nails. And here the 2 amps, the other 2 amps, this arm have a claw shaped structure. And it is used for levering out small tacks. And again we have screwdriver. Screwdriver are used for screwing or unscrewing screws used in woodwork. So screwdriver is used for screwing or unscrewing screws. Okay, then almost we have completed some of the carpentry tools. And then in addition, I would like to say some sharpening and grinding angles for chisels. There is a grinding angle for chisel is 25 degree and sharpening angle for chisel is 35 degree. And we have some of the carpentry process like marking, sawing, planing, chiseling, boring, grooving, riveting and molding. And we have some of the carpentry joints like open halfed joint, cross halfed joint. That is the halving joints. And again we have dovetail joints, dowel joints, mortise and tenon joints and corner joints, grooved joints, etc. Then we have completed successfully some of the carpentry tools like marking and measuring tools, planing tools, boring tools, etc. And just mentioning about the sharpening and grinding angle for chisel. And some of the carpentry process and carpentry joints. So we can see again with another topic. Thank you. Anyway, we can see again with another video. Before that, you should subscribe, share, like my channel. If you have any queries or doubt, you should contact to my email ID, hummandraofficial@gmail.com and come join it. Bye bye.